Shall we bow our heads in prayer? Our Heavenly Father, who art in heaven, thank you for giving us this glorious day to thank you once again. Thank you for giving us another opportunity to learn about you, to learn how we can associate and fellowship better with you. Thank you for giving us a great opportunity, for showing us that you are always around, always there, preserving us and keeping us in the right manner, in the right way. There is nothing other than thank you that we can say to you, O Lord. We love you, O Lord. We adore you. We give you all the glory, all the honor and praise in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you. You may be seated if you are standing, and you may continue if you are still sitting down. And I want to first begin by saying, it is just by the grace of God that we are here tonight. It's just by the grace of God that we are here tonight. Because we did experience a power outage, and it resulted in us delaying the service by so many hours. We apologize for that. It's not our doing, but it's the doing of, you see, some of these things, they don't just happen for happening's sake. One of the things you must always know to have at the back of your mind is that these things happen for unique reasons, unique purposes that you must take notice of keenly, because it may seem as a minor thing, but it serves as a great reason to thank the Lord. Hallelujah. The fact that we are here tonight is just a thanksgiving on its own. Today, yesterday, in fact, yesterday, I talked to you about thanksgiving. Today, I'm going to be talking to you about the importance of praise. Hallelujah. The importance of praise. So, first of all, we know what praise is. It's a way of according, words of goodness, affirmation to, somebody for an action or something beautiful that they've done. Do you understand? So it's something that we tell people that, oh, you've done very well with this work, you've done very well with that, continue and do this and do that, and many other things of that sort. I hope you understand where I'm coming from. Amen. So just for you to know, there is a great importance that is behind, us being here. And also there is a great importance mainly or focused at Thanksgiving. All right, I told you that Thanksgiving goes in hand with praise. Because when I'm thanking the Lord, you are going to be using words to thank Him as to what He has done for you. So, in other words, you are praising Him for what He has done for you. Yesterday, I told you in brief or in short that there's a lot that we need to be thankful for this year, especially as a Life Arena Church. We must be thankful for the people that God has given to us in the cell ministry. One of the main ways to obtain good things, permanent good things from the Lord, is through thanksgiving. It's through sacrifice. Because if you take notice of it, when you go into the book of Genesis and you look at the time or where the Abraham was able to receive the land for his people and his family that God had given unto him, he made a sacrifice. That sacrifice now locked that thing that God had given to him in. So thanksgiving is really a way, or it's really when you think about it very, very deeply, it's a sacrifice that we offer unto the Lord for something that He has done. And in order to lock it in, we continue to extol His name. We continue to remind ourselves of how good He has been to us. How many times have you been sick this year? I can't remember the last time I slept in a hospital. It's to the glory of God. Apart from me having the knowledge that I'm beyond limitation, far above every power of sickness, of disease, and every other thing of that sort, it is the grace of God who has made it available, or who has enabled me to be able to use this consciousness or this identity to work in the realms of the spirits. Because I did not be for God, I wouldn't have had that opportunity. Praise is a very important thing. We underestimate praise a lot. We don't really think that, oh, it's anything big. It's just praise. I mean, it's just saying thank you to the Lord. No, you can't just say thank you to the Lord and just leave. Thank you for what exactly? All right? Because you're saying thank you, Lord, but for what exactly? Thank you, Lord, for what exactly? First of all, why should we praise to the extent that it should be important? Psalm, the book of Psalm. I'm going to begin sharing with you now. Relax, we'll be here for a while today, maybe 12 a.m. over there. But most people get the chance to use night data. So, Psalm chapter 150. As creatures of God, we are required to do this. Psalm. That's the last chapter of the book of Psalm, and the sixth verse over there. KJV, normal KJV. It says, "Let everything that hath breath praise the Lord. Praise ye the Lord." Hallelujah. It says, "Let everything that hath breath praise the Lord." So you are mandated to, inasmuch as you are created fearfully and wonderfully made by God, there is a very great necessity for you to praise the Lord, because He has done all things bright and beautiful. He is the one who has given us this wonderful day to see. Who would think, or who would have thought, that's what I meant to say at first, who would have thought that we would live to see this hour, December 2023, and we are yet to see January 2024? Who would have thought I would have been born to see these glorious years of God's reign and God's kingdom? Who would have thought? It is all to the glory of God. Praise is important, number one. Praise is important because it signifies gratefulness. I want to take you somewhere in the book of Genesis, but not too far there, or else I may just end up putting you there. Amen. Let me just look for the scripture for you. No, take me back. I want to look for a certain scripture for you. Let me read it in. Okay. I'm coming. Oh, this is message. No. There's a certain scripture that I want to get for you. And it's one of the most, it shows how grateful you are, actually. And I'll show you the main reason as to why sacrifices show gratefulness, or why the praise is important, because it shows gratefulness. First of all, you need to understand that praise is like thanksgiving. That's why I said praise goes in hand with thanksgiving. Thanksgiving goes in hand with praise. It's like they are twins. If one is not there, the other is always there. And they both mean the same thing. However, praise is a bit different. Praise is aimed at just anything. Thanksgiving is looking at something generally and just being thankful or grateful for it. Hallelujah. All right. And hold on. I'll show you a few references. very soon or in just a few minutes. Genesis. The book of Genesis. Chapter 22, verse 6. Verse 6. And we are going to read all the way down to verse number 14. I read to you. And it says, and Abraham took the wood of the burnt offering and laid it upon Isaac his son. He took the fire in his hand and a knife, and they went both of them together. And Isaac spake unto Abraham his father and said, No, this isn't the part I'm looking for. Now, verse 11. And the angel of the Lord, no, 9. Yes, so here's what I want to show you. It says, and they came to the place which God had told him of. But Abraham built an altar there and laid the wood in order and bound Isaac his son and laid him upon the altar upon the wood. And Abraham stretched forth his hand and he took the knife to slay. Now, and the angel of the Lord called unto him out of heaven and said, Abraham, Abraham. And he said, Here am I am, or here am I. And he said, Lay not thine hand upon the lad, neither do thou anything unto him, for now I know that thou fearest God, seeing that thou hast not withheld thy son, thine only son from me. And Abraham lifted up his eyes and looked, and behold, behind him a ram caught in the thicket by his horns. And Abraham went and took the ram and offered him up for a burnt offering in the stead of his son. And Abraham called the name of that place Jehovah Jireh, as it is said to this day, in the mount of the Lord shall it be seen. Hallelujah. Praise be unto the glorious name of the Lord. So this scripture reading that we just read right now, people mostly mistaking it. People say that the Lord pointed to Abraham that he should go and sacrifice. No. Did you see anything like that there? In our entire reading, did you see anything like that there? There was nothing like that. There was nothing of that sort. The Lord never told Abraham to go and sacrifice anything. The only thing he asked him to do was to go and to use his son as a sacrifice. Once he did that, then that was where we had the ram. What did he say? He says, and Abraham lifted up his eyes. He after that which the Lord had told him, that of which the Lord had told him, he now lifted up his eyes, and lo and behold, he saw an animal, that is a ram caught in the bushes, and used that instead as the sacrifice to God. Ask yourself that, why would Abraham do that? Because God, if God says don't do it again, then meaning God does not really need a sacrifice. So this depicts to us two lenses over here. That's in strategic management and leadership, is the actual course. When you go inside, there's something called perspective lenses. When you there are certain ways you can look at a situation that can benefit one or deprive the other. Hallelujah. There are so many ways you can look at a situation that can benefit one and can, deprive the other. So all of these things, they are there. But anyway, that's the latter part of it. All that I want to say is that you can look at this in two ways. First of all, apart from the Lord testing Abraham, the Lord never said anything about a second sacrifice, or never told Abraham to go and sacrifice. The only thing he said, use him as a sacrifice for me. Apart from that, that was it. And this was even a test which Abraham knew not of. So since he knew not of what was going to happen, or he knew not of the test, he went to do what the Lord said. And he was going to do it, and the Lord said, stop, it's okay, I know you now trust me. Alright, sorry about that. So as I was saying, the Lord in this scripture never mentioned anything to Abraham that go and now sacrifice. Abraham was a wise man and knew that if God had been able to test him this way and did not use his son as a sacrifice, then it warrants that God doesn't need a sacrifice, but he wants to test your trust and to see the type of person that you really are. Because the reason for this exercise that you are seeing in the Bible right now is an exercise such that it depicts to us that sowing or giving yourself to, what do you call it? How do I even describe it for you to understand? Yes, sacrificing is a good thing. Because that's how it depicts it. Let me just try to break it down for you, because there are a lot of things that this scripture is saying. Okay, so first of all, when we notice the fact that God told him to sacrifice his son, that's devastating. This is his only son. There are people in the world that they've not given birth to one, and you'll give birth, and then now God will tell you, or tell this group of people who God gave them one child, that go and use your son as a sacrifice for me. How many of you would agree to that? Nobody. Because you know you suffered to get that son, that child. You know you suffered to get them. And at the end of the day, God wants you to give back. So the only thing you are likely to say is that you are not going to do it, or it's not God that is saying it, because God will never ask you to sacrifice your child for anything. God can. He did to Abraham. And funny enough, if you check something, he fulfilled the first type of sacrifice, which was accepting the sacrifice in the spirit and in the mind. Do you understand where I'm coming from? Okay, so notice this. He told him that sacrifice this. By understanding that, okay, there's a concept with sacrifice that God gives and then God takes. So by understanding this concept, once you are able to understand that concept and God tells you that sacrifice this amount of money, sacrifice this, sacrifice that. Of course, today in today's world, nobody would ask, God will not ask you to sacrifice anything. Even if you ask you to sacrifice a human being, he will tell you that let that human being do the work of God, or leave the human being to do the work of God as to is to be done. That's the only type of sacrifice. But for you to kill the human being, no. That's the Old Testament. We are in the New Testament, so we are looking at new things. The scriptures say, behold, if a man be in Christ, all things are passed away. Behold, all things are become new. Glory to God. So this should give us a clear picture or a clear example of who we really are, or the importance of praise. Because there are types of sacrifices. You don't just sacrifice. Okay, so the first one is the sacrifice of the spirit and the mind, of accepting that you are going to actually sacrifice something. Because most people will not accept it. They'll be like, ah, wait, I finally got a job. God want me to give all my salary. So now it's what? Now, this is why God gave us wisdom. God can tell you to do or do that as well. But, you know, the intention of God is to never keep you stranded. The intention of God is that you are never stranded. So be wise. Even if God tells you that give your salary, you didn't specify. So be wise. How much do you survive on? You check that, budget it, and then give the rest to God. And if God says give me everything, like he specifies, like give him everything, then you do it as such. First of all, you need to accept that God gives and then God takes. That is a concept of sacrifice. So once you are able to have that concept in your mind, now you are ready to go and sacrifice actually, by actually physically doing it. So when you really talk about praise is a sacrifice that takes place truly in the spirit. That's why the Bible says those who worship God must worship him in spirit and in truth. Do you understand where I'm coming from this evening? Yes. So if you really want to sacrifice, or you really want to see the sacrifice of praise, or you want to offer true praise unto the Lord, to see the real meaning of this annual thanksgiving that we are having, the only way you will find the real meaning of why we are having this annual thanksgiving is if you understand it according to and by the Spirit. That is why I'm always lost for words when I say there's a lot to thank the Lord for this year of 2023. There's a lot to thank him for, but just that we cannot describe it because it is in spirit. Those who are only in spirit will understand spiritual things. So now, Abraham understood that God give it, God take it. So he now took him. So that was the first stage of passing sacrifice. He passed the first sacrifice. Now, is the second one, which is actually the action or the doing. So he was coming to now do it. So as he was now coming to do what God asked him to do, then God said, stop. Lay no hand upon the lad. Do not do anything bad to him. But I now know that you fear me, for you even did not resist your own son from being used as a sacrifice. Now, it didn't mean that Abraham did not have a conscience. It did not mean that he did not have feelings. But this is the Lord we are talking about here. The Lord had prospered him to the extent that he had as many descendants as there are stars in the sky. We are all descendants of Abraham. Many, many nations behind. We are all descendants. If God has blessed him, he understood that sacrifice takes place with the Spirit. These are some of the things that are never documented in the Old Testament. So very little is said about it. But true sacrifice in this case takes place in spirits. So if you really want to praise the Lord and to understand the Lord, it takes place in the realm of the Spirit. That's how you really sacrifice and give thanks to the Lord. So when I always invite somebody, or when I always invite some of the cell leaders to come and give their testimony for annual thanksgiving or for any testimony service, and then they are like, oh, I don't have any testimony. What do you mean by you don't have a testimony? Is it that you don't notice what the Lord does for you, or you are just not ready to acknowledge the fact that the Lord has been gracious? Which is which? Because the ability to breathe, the ability to breathe is even a blessing on its own. For you to be doing this, some cannot do it. They are still in the hospital on drip. They are still in the hospital on air. Chemical air. You are breathing free air. That is also, listen, that's one of the greatest things. If you check the body, if you go into science and you examine the body, literally, you will find out so much that the Lord is just worthy of all the praise. The things in our body, if you just look at it, if you just look at the human body part practically, you can search on YouTube. That's why there's online today. Or you can ask AI to do it for you. You can always search, and then it will show you pictorial images of our body parts. And you will see that although the Lord formed dust and breathed the breath of God in it, as he breathed the breath of God, he breathed good things into us. And that is what makes us human beings. That's what makes us man and woman. This is a testimony on its own. The fact that we are a creation, that we can be acknowledged as a creation of God, is just a blessing on its own. I'm telling you, do not be ungrateful to the Lord this season. Nobody should have to tell you that you need to be thankful to the Lord before you actually prove yourself worthy of giving him thanks. If somebody needs to prove this to you, then it means that you are too proud to notice. And it is very wrong, and it must be stopped. Nobody should tell you that you should give thanks unto the Lord before you give thanks unto the Lord. It means that really, you don't really value what the Lord does for you. And this is the type of people that will always lose the good things that the Lord has brought to them. So check the span of your life. How much have you appreciated God in this year, in last year, in 2 years ago, 3 years ago? How is it like? How is your life now? Compare both of them together. And don't just compare any type of way. Compare in spirit and in truth. Compare in spirit and be truthful to yourself. Be honest to yourself. That when you were thankful to the Lord, how was your life then? Now that you are also thankful, how is your life now? Are you listening to me? How was your life then? And now, how is your life? Has it changed? Yes. If you don't thank the Lord will continue to extract from you or take from you what he has given you. Why? Because he hasn't seen you being appreciated for it. It is like you give somebody a gift on Christmas Day and then the person doesn't really show any reaction. Of course, you would ask questions like, do you not like the gift? And I mean, do you not like the gift? And the person will just take it away and say, I'll bring back another one. Or I'll come back later, maybe. Do you not like the gift? That's God. He's asking, now, do you not like what I've given to you? Can you not see all these things that I've given to you? The ability to even breathe, to open your mouth and to talk the same every morning, to open your eyes and they are still working, to move your legs and they are still working, to play ball and you are still playing it. All these things are reasons to be thankful for the Lord in this season. Boys have been playing ball the whole of this year. It's a reason to be thankful. I just wish that they were here to hear this. Because what you are not thankful for, the Lord will take away. You need to show him that you are thankful for it. Now, when it comes to the giving part of thanksgiving, by now you should have so many points. I've only given you 1 point, but by now you should have so many points. You should be taking points down yourself. As I was saying, one of the things that you need to notice is that there are aspects to giving or sacrifice. There's sacrifice physically and then spiritually. Physically, is not really necessary. And that is not really what the Lord looks at. Spirituality is what the Lord looks at. Oh yes, before you give an offering, the Lord looks at you first, examines you, and now sees that, are you really excited about what you are giving? The offering now, woman, that is why I always say in this church, the Love Arena, if you know that the offering is not from your heart, you don't want to give it, please put your wallet down. Nobody has sent you. Don't come and cause panic or wreck havoc and just be walking about just free like that. Because once it's not from your heart, God knows that you are not pleased. It's a curse, automatic curse. There are automatic curses that we actually obtain when we do certain things. That's why we must always ask for the grace and the mercy of God upon our life. And the fact that the Lord always gives it to us is just a reason to be thankful. Like I'm saying, there's a lot to be thankful for. If you look at the year in a whole, and you look at the amount of events that we've done, come on. This can only be the doing of the Lord. Even in times where I thought it wouldn't be able to happen, the Lord made it sure. The Lord told me that it can happen, and it can happen greater than you think. It can happen, and it can happen greater than you think. This song ministry week, 12-hour prayer chain, I never knew that we could do it again. We've done 24 hours, but it was the grace of God that was available that helped us do the 12 hours as well. It's something to be thankful for. The ability that I'm able to do services on end without getting tired is just a reason to be thankful. Some will start ministry and will be like, it's too much work, it's too hard, I cannot do it. And then we'll just quit. They'll just leave the job somewhere. Praise is very important. Because one thing about praise is that one, or just a reason, but I'll tell you that praise is important, is because it helps you to obtain or to keep the things that the Lord actually wants to give to you or allow for you. Acknowledgement is also a part of thanksgiving. So thanksgiving is like acknowledging or noticing the fact that God has done it for you. And you are back to say thank you or to show gratitude. It's the same with every other thing in the Bible. If you don't acknowledge the fact that you are above principalities and powers through Christ Jesus, you will always experience sickness. But once you acknowledge it, you live the life, the practical life of that scripture, sickness cannot touch you again. Listen, this whole year, I've not been to the hospital once. Same thing last year. Maybe once or twice last year, but that was it. This year, nada. I've not stepped in the hospital once for anything. Look at all the sicknesses that are running around. It's not like people are not falling sick. It's not like I don't go out too. I go out, but I associate with people a lot. They are airborne diseases, but it's the grace and the glory of God that has kept us. There's so much to be thankful for. Don't be ungrateful in this season. And the more you're ungrateful, the more you lose. The more you find less reason to appreciate what the Lord has actually done for you, the more you actually lose gradually what God actually wants to give to you. You lose it gradually. Gradually, you realize that it's driving away from you, just going. It's just going, waving, bye-bye, and it's gone. Don't allow anything to go away from you. Some of you were living a very wonderful and a beautiful life. Ask yourself that, when was the last time you were thankful for all the things that the Lord has done for you in this year or in the year? You are always complaining about something. You're always complaining about what God has not done. You're always complaining about society. You're always complaining about economic crisis. What about the sure word of the Lord? What about the fact that the Lord preserved you all this economic crisis? What about the fact that the Lord preserved you and enlightened you with knowledge to live your life in the upright way that you may survive up to now? What about that? So ask yourself, the people whose lives are basa here, I'm talking to you. If you know that your life, I'm not saying that your life is basa. I'm also not saying that your life is not. I didn't say it though. I'm also not saying that it is. I'm not saying that your life is basa. I'm also not saying that your life is not basa. Do you understand? But just take a look. This is just an honest exercise that you must take notice of. Just take a look. When was the last time you were thankful to the Lord for what He has done for you? When was the last time? Just cast your mind back. Always complain about this, always complain about it. It's not always about complaining. It's not always about complaining. This season, that is tomorrow, in fact, this morning, we are going to be having our last annual Thanksgiving service. It's 12 a.m. We're going to be having our last annual Thanksgiving service this morning. This morning, find a reason to be thankful. And even at this service, as now, as we speak, we are still on day two, as far as I'm concerned. As far as I'm concerned, we are still on day two. Find a very, very good reason to thank the Lord this year. Please, when you are looking at reasons to thank the Lord, don't just look at physical, spiritually. You use spirituality to look physical. It's a coded thing. You go in the spirit first, and then you look at all the things in the physical that the Lord has done for you. Then you understand the essence of each and every one of them, even the smallest detail. And that's how we see thankful people. So you don't look at the physical before you come and look at the spiritual. You use the spiritual to look at the physical. Because the spiritual is a lens that helps you to see greater things. That's why when we are looking at a prophet, we look at how far he can see in the realm of the physical through the spiritual. Because you are spiritual, therefore you look at things from a spiritual perspective. So when you do that, everything that is spiritual, you can see right in front of you, displayed at your convenience. It's displayed right in front of you. So a prophet can just be sitting there. I can see that there's a demon behind you. I can see that this, I can see that. He's looking at you, or he's looking at the physical realm with a spiritual perspective. That's why he has the ability to do that. And it's a gift. And it stays because they are thankful for it. So this reason, this season, find a good reason to really thank the Lord. I shouldn't be telling you to give your Thanksgiving offering. You know what the Lord has done for you. I've given you a way to know the importance of praise and how to really thank the Lord genuinely. I told you that from now all the way to next year, December, is a home of Thanksgiving. Thanksgiving shall never pass us by. Hallelujah. We will continue to thank the Lord for all his gracious attempts and glory and every good thing in our life. Hallelujah. Let us pray. Father who art in heaven, we thank you and we praise your holy name in this glorious moment and season in time that you've given to us. I believe that as you've gathered here today, you have given us a reason to be happy and joyous. Continue to shower us with your blessing, O Lord. Continue to enlighten us and change our rank according to the riches of your glory. We are thankful, O Lord. Thank you every day. In Jesus' name, amen. God bless you.